Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a topic that is a forward PE ratio. One of the most important ratio which every analyst they consider for valuation purpose or for analyzing the EPS and the price of the share. So every stakeholder is also interested in this. The forward PE ratio is the price per share divided by the forecasted EPS over the next 12 months. So there is only one difference. I mean, what is the next thing that we are going to study is what is the forward PE ratio? This is our next thing. Now, there is only one difference between PE ratio of a company and a PE ratio of a firm, of the same firm. The difference is only the earnings that we use to calculate. In PE ratio, we use the earnings of previous years. Okay. However, in case of the forward PE, we use the projected earnings of the next year. That's the only difference. This is EPS normal and this is F, the forward EPS. Basically, over here, the forward projected EPS has been used to calculate the PE ratio. So like the PE ratio, the forward PE is also a great measure of whether a company's financial health, financially it is healthy or not. But you know, every investor need to look at the bunch of the financial ratios along with the forward price earning ratio to come up with the conclusion that whether they should invest in a company or not. Now we'll understand the formula. See, the formula for the forward PE earning ratio is just an extension of the formula of the PE ratio. The formula is quite simple, that it's just the price per share divided by the EPS forecasted of the next 12 months. Okay, the first component is the market price per share. As per the market price at which the potential shareholders would buy the stocks of the company and can change over time. So at different times, the market price would vary. We need to divide the market price by the number of outstanding shares of the company to find out the market price per share. The second component is the projected EPS. So as an investor, you can look at the different publication or you can hire a financial analyst and take her or his help to find out an estimate. So this the forward EPS is your projected earnings divided by the number of outstanding shares of the company. Okay, so using this formula, will also help the investor to know how much a company will earn per share, and they can use the same formula to find out about the forward PE ratio too. Now, let's get into the example zone so that you will get some idea regarding the same. Now, let's take two examples of forward or one. Let's see, the first one would be simplistic and where everything would be given. The second example, if it's a little bit complex, the forward PE ratio. Let's say there's Jill is a new in stock investing and she wants to know whether she would invest in, let's say, Bourbon and Company, Bourbon Limited, a biscuit company. And she has basically asked his brother, who's in stock investments for quite a while. Her brother, Jack, advises she should basically look at the bunch of the financial ratio. Jill figured out all the ratios except the forward price earning ratio. So let's help Jill find out the ratio by using some of the information that we have. Price which she found, the market price of the stock is, the total market price of the stock is, let's say, 1 million. The number of shares outstanding, okay, is 1 lakh, let's say. And the projected earnings, is for the next year. This is, we are talking about the next year, let's say, is 5 lakh. So we'll calculate the forward PE ratio by splitting the example, into two parts. First, we'll calculate the market price per share. And then this is the, not the price. This is actually the market cap. Okay. So the first and the foremost thing that we are going to do is, you calculate the market price per share and then we'll find out the forward EPS. So the market price per share is MPS is equal to your total market cap divided by the number of shares. So in this scenario, we had something that's called 1 million as the market cap divided by the number of shares, that is 1 lakh. So that gives us our P0 or MPS as 10. To find out the forecasted EPS, we need to use the formula, that is the forward EPS, okay, FEPS, which is your projected earnings per share divided by the number of outstanding shares. So your projected earning is 5 lakh divided by the total number of share 1 lakh. That gives us an EPS of 5. So this is 10 over here and this is 5 price and the EPS, right? So finally, based on this, you can calculate your forward PE ratio, that is forward PE, which is your market price per share divided by FEPS, which will give you 2 per share. Let's take another example quickly. Let's say Mr. Amit wants to calculate the forward PE earning ratio of Buddha Jeans Limited, and they know the issue, he doesn't have all the information. He only knows the PE ratio of the company. He only knows that, and also he knows something that is called EPS. Now he also has a consensus report that says that the projected earning, I mean, they're just writing P, that is the projected earnings of the company, would be 1 million the next year, the coming year. Help, you know, you need to help out the we'll need to help out Amit to find out the forward price earning ratio by using the formula. So let's say the PE details that he had was the PE ratio was 4. The EPS, that details he had, was 15 per share, and the number of outstanding shares was 1 lakh. Okay, so we have been given with the PE ratio and the EPS, right? And, you know, we can find the PE ratio with the help of market price per share, that is MPS, divided by the EPS, right? So we know that the PE ratio is over here is 4, and EPS over here is 15. So MPS is empty. So it's as simple as that. It's 15 into 4. That's 60, right? So that should be the share price, right? 60 per share. Now to find out the forward price earning ratio, we need to calculate the last piece of information, that is the forward EPS, that is FEPS, right? So to find out the forward EPS, we'll use the formula as FEPS is equal to your earnings divided by the number of shares. Right now, forward EPS is equal to your earnings, which is 1 million, as which is visible above, divided by the total number of shares, which is 10,000. So our final answer is going to be 1 million divided by 1 lakh, that is 10 per share. So we have all the information that we need to find out for the forward PE earning ratio, which is the market price that was 60 that we just found, divided by the 10, that is the forward PE, which will give us our forward EPS, which will give us our forward PE as 6. So this is our forward EPS, right? I hope you have got the example. And now this is a scenario for the forward PE ratio of Amazon. The Amazon current share price 1586.51 as on 20th March. The quarter ending 8.31 and 15.39. So the forward EPS is 8.31 for December 2018 and 15.39 for December 19. So the forward PE ratio calculation is going to be the share price divided by 2018 forecasted EPS and 2019 forecasted EPS is 190.91 and 103.08. This is the calculator, you know, that you can use and analyze. Let's say the market price is 1000 and the projected earning per share is, let's say, 10. So your forward PE has to be 100. Now let's reduce the earning. So as your earning reduces, your forward PE ratio will increase. And as your market price will increase, as your market price will reduce, your forward PE should also reduce. So this is the calculator that you can use and make some good conclusions out of the same, and happy learning. Thank you, everyone.